Hello and welcome back, it's Vicky here with another card making video. Today I'm going to share 5 different projects using products from the latest release by my favorite things. Just like every month, the October release has something for everyone, adorable stamp sets, and I will start with the Selfies with Santa. This will give you 6 images that you can use either in combination or completely separately for creating your projects. I just picked one of them, and you can repeat the same card design with any of the images from this stamp set. I'm using Extreme Black Ink by My Favorite Things to stamp my image, and that's because it is alcohol marker friendly. I will use my alcohol markers to color everything, and just because I'm sharing 5 projects in one video today, I'm not going to share loads about how I did the coloring. I always do quick and simple coloring, by the way. And for this image, I mainly stayed with reds and greens, since I'm going for a traditional color-themed Christmas card. By the way, I'm using my Spectrum Noir Triblends, which come with 3 shades of color in one barrel, just because I find that they are super easy to play with. So I have everything ready. This little guy there, if depending on how you color him, he can be a penguin or a little birdie. I went with a penguin. Now I'm using a rectangle die to cut this out, and the idea is to have it look as if it is a Polaroid photo. So I will run it through my die cutting machine, and here is what I have. And I think that it looks quite long as it is, so I will chop off just a little bit from the bottom to make it look better. I'm just eyeballing everything, I don't know the exact measurements of a Polaroid photo. And it doesn't really matter. So with this big stamp set, you can create many of those Polaroid photos with different images every time, and you can stack them on top of your project. However, I'm going to show you how you can work with just one of them. I'm going to stamp my sentiment at the bottom that says "From all of us." This is a perfect card to give along with a Christmas gift. My card base is a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5. I have a light gray panel that I'm going to stick on top. This is slightly smaller than my standard card. And then on top, I'm going to stick my Polaroid photo. If you want, you can pop it up with some foam tape. I'm just going to glue it down. And then just for the fun of it, I will use this paper pad, again from the latest collection, and I picked one of the pattern papers. I'm going to cut out a thin strip of paper, which then I'm going to tear with my fingers to have a small piece that looks like washi tape. And I will stick it on top of my photo as if it is the washi tape that holds that Polaroid in place. To embellish my card, I'm going to use my Nouveau Drops, and I will add some white dots here and there. They are going to look like snow. And I even went through my stash to find tiny little dies that cut out snowflakes so that I could stick them on top of my card for some extra embellishment. For my next card, I will work with this tiny stamp set, which is adorable. This is the Fairy and Bright stamp set. It gives you a cat and a dog. And you know me, I just had to go with the cat. Here is how I colored everything, mainly stayed with greens, and I got inspiration from the colors of this pattern paper. I believe this is one from a previous collection from last month, if I'm not mistaken. I do have a dark green cardstock, which I'm going to cut out with a rectangle die that has a lovely stitching. It always gives a finished look. And I also picked one of the pattern papers from this paper pad. This is my favorite for sure, love the color combination here. With a darker shade of green, I just quickly added some inking all around the edges just to darken it up a little bit. This is going to give the illusion that the center of the panel is glowing. And then this is a very simple design to put together, so I'm placing my green panel on top of the pattern paper, and I did have foam tape at the back. I did stamp my sentiment on white cardstock, but you will see that I changed my mind in the finished photos. I didn't like how bright white that was, and I would just change it in green. You will see that in a bit. And then on top I'm going to stick my little guy and the girl. I did grab one of the dies that I had in my stash to cut out a bunch of little stars. This one is called Star Pops, and it is a dye that I had for ages, but you can always use sequins or gems instead of stars. It's a super adorable card, and I think the sentiment looks better in green. And I don't know how my favorite things do it every time, but look how adorable all the stamp sets are. This is called It's Penguin to Look a Lot Like Christmas, and it comes with all those penguins doing different things. I'm going to choose one of them. I went with the one on the candy cane, and that was a super easy image to color, just black and red, and you are good to go. Now I'm working on a small white panel, and I'm just blending in a little bit of distress oxide. I'm going with tumbled glass just because it is very light. I don't go for the perfect blending here. I like to have kind of splotches. They look like clouds. I also grabbed those two dies that cut out slopes. These are again very, very old. They are the ones that I keep on using again and again for creating hills or snowbanks, etc. These are a must in your stash if you like to create little scenes. So I'm going to play with the curves a little bit and try to decide how I like them to go at the back, and then I'm going to stick them down. Now for one of them I'm going with glue. This is going to go completely flat at the back, and then for the other snowbank, to add some dimension, I will stick it down with some foam tape. And of course for this card I'm using one of my favorite recipes when I work with critters, which is creating a scene. I did share a video with those recipes. If you haven't seen that, I will make sure to link it at the end of this one. And then I have to stick on top my little guy, again by using foam tape so that he is leveled with the top snowbank. And of course in a scene like this one you can add snow at the background, just like I did in the first card. For example, you can use your nouveau drops, or you can go with sequins. For some strange reason I decided for this card not to add snow at all, but I will embellish it with other ways. So I'm picking one of the pattern papers that matches perfectly with the blues and the reds on my card. And then I grabbed this stamp set. This is called Put the Jolly in the Holidays, another adorable critter stamp set. But from this one I will only use the matching dies to cut out the trees. These are perfect to complete my little scene. I used just three of them. They really make a difference on the card and create that depth that I wanted. I glued all three trees with my Barely Art glue down so that they are flat with the background. I didn't want them to pop. All I want to have at the foreground is the little guy. Then in the same stamp set there are tiny little hearts and matching dies to cut them out, so I'm just going to play around a little bit, decide where I want them to go, and I will stick them down. And because sometimes I don't know when to stop when I'm creating a little scene and I can keep on adding things, I decided to add some clouds on my sky as well. This is a die that I have again for years. It's one of those things that I like to have in my arsenal for when I create scene cards. And finally I'm sticking down the sentiment. This is white embossed, and it's just a part of a whole phrase from the same stamp set. And again, you can add snow if you like, I just decided not to. Here are some close-up photos on this card. And for my fourth project, I will use this die set. This is a standalone die set, it doesn't come with a matching stamp set. And it is called Nativity Silhouette. If you don't have any nativity dies, then this is a great set for you. It gives you lots and lots of dies to play with to create a nativity scene, and if you like creating cards for Christmas that really have a meaning instead of using critters or snowflakes, then this is a great set to go. For my little card I'm keeping everything simple, which is going to make it easy to recreate if you want this to be your Christmas card this year. I'm only going to cut out the star out of gold cardstock. I cut out everything so you can see what you get. These are all the dies included, lovely, and it is great if you want to create a slimline card. However, I'm going for an A2 standard card, and I'm going to use just a few of them, as many as I can fit on top of my card. For my background, I'm starting with a navy blue cardstock, And I'm going to ink it up mainly at the top to darken it up a little bit. For that, I'm working with chipped sapphire distress ink. This is not the oxides. And to darken it up even more, I'm going to bring in a little bit of dark soot. However, if you plan to mass produce this card, you really don't have to do the blending. Just cut out dark blue panels and you are good to go. At the bottom of my panel, I placed a white strip of paper. And then on top of that, I'm going to stick a very thin strip of cold cardstock. This is going to add a touch of shine on my card. And that's the same cardstock that I used to cut out the star. Notice that I decided to use an A2 standard card size, however, in landscape orientation. This way I will be able to stick more of that die cuts and create a bigger scene. And believe it or not, although I am crafting for so many years, I don't have another nativity die set, so I was super happy that my favorite inks came up with this one. I am also going to stick the star at the sky. And of course you have plenty of space at the bottom to stamp your sentiments. I simply went with Merry Christmas, and this comes from the Itty Bitty Holiday stamp set that has lots and lots of sayings, which is perfect for this type of cards. In the beginning I was thinking to stick more stars on my sky, smaller ones, however I decided not to. It is better to add little white dots with your gel pen, since it makes the star look brighter. Simply stick this panel on an A2 card base and you are good to go. It's a lovely card with meaning, and at the same time you can easily mass produce it. Now this is the For You from Santa little stamp set that comes with a Santa along with stamps that you can layer on top to color him. There is a whole bunch of these stamps that you can mix and match together. For example, this big one is called Gifts from Santa. They have the exact same style. They are easy to use because you don't have to color anything. Everything is ready for you. And there is a whole collection if you look on the My Favorite Things website. So I decided to go with this guy here who is holding the presents. And instead of creating a card, I'm going to make a little box. Remember that you can use any stamp as a focal point on a card, but also you can add it on a gift tag as well as on top of a box to embellish it. I stamped the outline with black ink. Now I'm just rubbing my palm on top of the stamp because it is quite solid, and this is the layer. I'm using red ink for that. This way you can easily create these type of guys quick and simply without having to color anything. And then there is another layer for adding color on the boxes. Just because I'm planning to use that pattern paper again that has those blues, the teal blues and the reds, I decided to go with teal blue for the gifts. Then I used the matching dies to cut him out. And finally, I'm going to create my box. This is a new die set from the latest release. It is called Everyday Gift Box, and it gives you dies, lots of them, to create not only the box but also panels to embellish the box, as well as dies to cut out sentiments and gift tags. You will find that if you make the box, it is going to fit perfectly a gift card, but you can also fit inside little treats or even jewelry, for example earrings, or if you want to gift a necklace and things like that. Now, depending on how you choose to embellish it, it can be a gift box for pretty much any occasion. I am going for a Christmas one today, and for that I'm going to pick a pattern paper for the top of the box. And of course I chose to go with reds and teal since it matches the color of my Santa. For the bottom of the box I already did the die cutting out of white cardstock. So I have here both my pieces. The one that doesn't have the scalloped edges is the one at the bottom. So you can go completely neutral there. I chose to go with white. And it is really easy to put together. I'm just using my bone folder to make sure that I have a nice crease. And then all you do is to add glue on the flaps and just put the box together. It is meant to hold a gift card. But you can see it has some depth, so you can wrap with tissue paper your gift card if you like. You can even throw in a few small candy. And let's make the top. The top is easy to recognize, is the one with the scalloped edges, and that's why I use the pattern paper there. Again, I'm repeating the same process, just making sure that I have good folds everywhere with my bone folder. And then on those flaps, I'm adding a little bit of glue. And once you are sure that both those boxes are nicely glued together, you can see they fit perfectly one on top of the other. Now let's embellish it a little bit to make it more fun. I did use one of the dies to cut out this little panel that fits on top of the box. I also stamped no peeking with red ink, and then I'm going to stick the Santa on top. And of course you can take it a step further if you want. You can keep the box closed by tying some ribbon or some thread. However, I'm keeping it simple. I think it looks adorable as it is. And these were the projects for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Just like always, down below in the description area, you will find links to everything I used. Don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends if you had fun watching. And also leave me a comment down below and let me know which one of those projects was your favorite. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.